what is an atom? Before we get into what they're made of, what exactly is an atom? There's a couple different ways you can go about this. Jack?
The smallest particle of an element?
Okay, it's the smallest particle. It's the smallest thing that you can go down to and still say you have that element. So if I have a block of gold, well, all the atoms in that block of gold are gold. I can take just one atom out of that block of gold, and I'll still have gold. It still retains all the properties of gold. It's a very small piece, but it's still gold. After that, if you break the atom down into its subatomic particles, you don't have gold anymore. So atoms are as far as you can go. Anyone have another definition?
The simplest form of a pure substance?
It's the simplest form of a pure substance. So elements are the purest of substances created. Were they made? Where are our elements made? Stars, yeah. So these are the things that were made in the cores of stars when we talk about astronomy. Simplest form of pure substance, basic building blocks of matter. All these definitions are good for what an atom is. All right. So atom, we could break it down into things called subatomic particles. And there are a lot more than what we cover, but this is really all you need to know for your MCAS. The atom has a core. We call it a
nucleus.
The nucleus. The nucleus contains two of the subatomic particles. What would those be?
Protons and neutrons.
Protons and neutrons. The outside of the nucleus has the third subatomic particle, and we call those the Liam. Outside the nucleus is the
electrons.
The electrons, and we find them in the cloud. All of the weight, atom's mass, all of the mass of an atom comes from what part of the atom? The electrons or the nucleus?
The nucleus.
The nucleus. So what two subatomic particles have mass?
Protons
and neutrons, because they're found in the nucleus. Electrons are said to have very, very little mass. Does anyone remember reading how small they are compared to like a proton or a neutron?
1/1,086.
Yeah, it's about 1/2,000th of the mass of a proton or neutron. So we say they're relatively massless. And they're whizzing around the nucleus in specific orbits. And they're almost going the speed of light. And we'll get into that a little bit more as we go on. Okay, so the three subatomic particles in an atom are protons, neutrons, and electrons. Protons and neutrons are found in that core of the nucleus. Electrons are found on the outside. Atoms are neutrally charged. It means they're not positive or they're not negative. So these subatomic particles, actually, some of them have charges on them for atoms to be neutral. So let's just cover this real quick. Protons. What charge does a proton have?
Positive.
What charge does an electron have?
Negative.
And the neutrons in the nucleus, those are
neutral.
They don't have a charge at all. And in an atom, the number of protons, positive things, and the number of electrons, negative things, are equal. So they cancel each other out, and atoms are neutrally charged. In nature, it doesn't tend to work that way. We have things called ions, which we'll get into, and that's what makes atoms stick together to make other compounds that make up the matter that we know of. Okay, so let's look at a picture of this. So I've put up two examples, lithium and carbon. Lithium, what's its atomic number? Here, we can start going to the periodic table a little bit. Atomic number, lithium would be, Tiffany?
Three.
Number three, right. And that three has some significance, which we'll do in a minute. But you can see here, the protons are blue, the neutrons are yellow, and then on the outside are the electrons, and these are the electron rings, or the cloud. And we'll get to the rules on how many can fit on each ring a little bit later, if not next time. So for lithium, how many protons does it have? Gloria, how many protons? Lithium.
Three.
Has three. Blue, one, two, three. How many neutrons does it have?
Three.
It has three. One, two, three. Three yellow things. And how many electrons does it have?
Three.
It has three, right. So, now go to your periodic table. What was lithium's number again, Tiffany?
Three.
Three. What does that three stand for? It's not neutrons. It all comes down to the proton. Your atomic number tells you how many protons the element has. So protons determine the element. Carbon, how many protons? Look at your periodic table. What is carbon's atomic number?
Six.
Six. So the atomic number tells you how many protons are in the element. If I take a proton away from carbon, and I can't, but let's say I could, what do I have now?
Boron.
Agreement? I take one proton away from carbon, what do I have?
Boron.
Chris?
Boron.
I got boron, right. And that's how it works. Number of protons is the atomic number. I can take neutrons away, or add neutrons, or nature can, but you still retain carbon as long as there's six protons. So neutrons can be added or removed, and even electrons can be added or removed. So if I take a, and it can't happen, but let's say an electron, take an electron away from carbon, it's still carbon. It would be ionized, but it would be carbon, and carbon doesn't do that, so that's kind of a bad example. Okay. Sodium, how many protons? Let's go around. Paula?
11.
11. How many electrons does it have then?
11.
It has 11. They have to equal. Remember, atoms are not charged. So if it is an atom, it's got 11 protons and 11 electrons. How about nickel? How many protons? Protons. Look at your chart or look at mine. Anya?
28.
28. So here's nickel. What happens if I add a proton to nickel? What do I get?
Copper.
Copper.
I get the next element, which would be copper. So protons determine the element. So that atomic number on our periodic tables is the one up top. That just tells you how many protons you have. And if it's an atom, it's got the same number of electrons also. Finding neutrons is a little more tricky, but not so much. We said that the total mass of the atom comes from the nucleus. All right, so your atomic mass, if you look on your vocab, atomic mass is the number of protons and neutrons in an atom. And that number is usually found, and on your periodic table, it's found, here, let me give you this one right here. This would be your atomic mass. Now, what do you notice about the atomic mass? The definition is total number of protons and neutrons in an atom. Why does that number look a little funny to you?
How do you get a half of
that? How do you get a 0.811 of a proton or a neutron, right? You can't. So what they, boron comes, has different isotopes. It has some forms of boron have more or less neutrons, and since neutrons add mass, they're going to add to the mass of the atom. So they, scientists, we all chemists, know what types of boron are out there and how much of it is out there. So they take all the naturally occurring isotopes and then they make an average. So this is an average of all the naturally occurring isotopes, and that's where you get your atomic mass. When we want to find out how many neutrons there are, that number, you know, you can't be in a decimal form. So I have to give you an exact whole number. So if and which will be the mass number. If the mass number is 11, so I'm going to tell you for boron, the mass number is 11. How many neutrons does boron have? Work it out. Do you know how many protons it has?
5.
Do you know what the total mass is? 11.
6.
So how many neutrons?
6.
6 neutrons, 5 protons, equals a mass number of 11. And that's how you find neutrons. Let's do a couple more. Let's do carbon. I'm going to tell you that the mass number for carbon is going to be, we're going to just make it 12. Tell me how many protons, tell me how many electrons, and tell me how many neutrons. Take 15 seconds. Go ahead. Don't yell it out. All right, Jack, you're up. Protons in carbon.
6.
Electrons in an atom of carbon?
6.
And the number of neutrons in the example that I gave you with a mass number of 12?
6.
Are they always going to be equal?
No.
666 or 555?
No.
No, they're not. Neutrons don't always equal electrons and protons. All right, let's do oxygen. I'm going to tell you the mass number is 16. How many protons, neutrons, electrons? Want to try it, Liam?
No.
Go ahead, Liam. You can do it.
I forget what you do.
You just did it.
This number tells you the number of?
Electrons.
It does in an atom, yes, but more specifically, the atomic number always tells you number of? This is what makes the element an element.
Neutrons?
No.
Protons.
Protons. This is your protons. This is the total weight of the atom, protons and neutrons together. So if there's 8 protons, how many neutrons are there?
8.
There would be 8. And if it's an atom, how many electrons does it have?
8.
It would have 8. Right. Okay, so we're going to do a lot more practice on that down the road. This is just your first day with it. All right. Timmy Wobey?
Sure.
Okay, this is a little bit about the history on how they figured out. Because atoms are so small, and you can't just look at them under a microscope, really, or at least in the 100 years ago, they didn't have that kind of technology. So they had to use evidence of what was happening when they were doing experiments to understand what atoms were made of, because they couldn't see these subatomic particles. They're so tiny. You can fit like 10 million atoms on a little period point on a piece of paper. So atoms are really, really tiny. And it's kind of interesting how they figured this out.
Dear Tim and Moby, what in the world are atoms? From Chris. What in the world isn't an atom? Air, water, pants, leaves, robots, and humans are all made up of atoms. This is the periodic table of elements, and when you take chemistry, it becomes your best friend. This chart shows and predicts every known element in the universe: oxygen, iron, lead, and so on. These elements are all made of atoms. Around 2,400 years ago, a Greek guy named Democritus argued that everything in the world was made up of particles so small they could not be cut in half. He called these tiny things atoms, from the Greek word atomos, which means indivisible. In the 1800s, another guy named John Dalton refined the idea with his theory that atoms are the smallest particle of an element that retains its chemical properties. That means if you break apart an atom of an element like carbon, it's not carbon anymore.